A new and unfolding democracy is how Emmerson Mnangagwa describes his ascent to power, even if it took military intervention to end Robert Mugabe's presidency. Tens of thousands of Zimbabweans waited for hours to watch Mnangagwa's swearing into office. An inauguration meant to cement the veneer of a politically driven solution from within the ruling ZANU-PF party.
Whilst we cannot change the past, there is a lot we can do in the present and the future to give our nation a different positive direction.
Mnangagwa's promise to implement economic reforms that would uplift the lives of millions of Zimbabweans left jobless in a battered economy and work towards stimulating local industries as well as compensating white farmers for the land they lost under previous policies. He's also vowed to fight corruption, a tall order, given the corruption allegations faced by many members of his ruling party.
Often from politicians we have learned that there is a gulf between what they say and what they actually do. The same government that he is coming from the same party that he leads now, promised people 2 million jobs in 2013, and those jobs have not yet been created.
Mnangagwa enjoys firm military backing from the same army that in 2008 intervened in elections lost by Mugabe, ensuring he stayed in power.
One of the major things that we're worried about now is that we know we are faced with an election in 2018. What happens if this new president loses that election? Will the military be able to hold their horses and stay in the barracks and say, we'll respect the will of the people?
Mnangagwa has promised free and fair elections next year. He still has U.S. sanctions hanging over his head from his time serving the Mugabe regime for what it called acts to undermine democracy. But Mnangagwa says now is the time to re-engage with the West.
For people here, President Mnangagwa certainly made all the right noises, talking directly about the needs of everyday Zimbabweans. He's moved away from traditional political issues, instead addressing people's concerns about his presidency. But the worry is that Zimbabweans could one day face a crisis of expectation, with apparently well-intentioned economic and political plans unlikely to work overnight. Fahmida, Al Jazeera, Harare, Zimbabwe.